Vomiting is a common reason that owners bring their dogs to the veterinarian. In fact, market research conducted by Pfizer Animal Health has shown that veterinarians see an average of 28 vomiting dogs every month. Vomiting is often associated with a number of different medical conditions, including dietary indiscretion, gastritis or gastroenteritis, parvovirus, motion sickness, GI obstruction, pancreatitis, or renal disease. With so many potential causes, it's not surprising that diagnosis can be challenging and treatment can be frustrating. Because of the range of underlying conditions, no standard treatment approach exists. When a dog vomits and the owner calls the veterinarian, a number of approaches may be discussed. Depending on the situation, the instruction might be to watch and wait, withhold food and water, feed a bland diet, try over-the-counter remedies, or bring the dog in for veterinary care. If vomiting persists or worsens, prescription medications may be tried with varying degrees of success, while the underlying condition continues to be explored. To fully understand canine emesis and how to treat, let's look at the mechanisms and pathways that mediate this physical reflex. Vomiting is controlled by a cluster of brainstem nuclei collectively known as the emetic center, where all vomiting stimuli ultimately converge. These stimuli can travel through two pathways, central and peripheral. Stimuli that travel the central pathway go directly to the emetic center from higher brain centers. Stimuli that travel the peripheral pathway can go directly to the emetic center via neural afferents or indirectly to the emetic center via the chemoreceptor trigger zone, or CRTZ, an area of the brain which detects circulating toxins. Here are some examples. Dietary indiscretion is a condition that causes vomiting stimuli to travel directly to the emetic center. Liver failure is a disease that causes vomiting stimuli to travel indirectly to the emetic center via the CRTZ. But not all diseases generate vomiting impulses that reach the emetic center by one route alone. For instance, renal failure may trigger vomiting signals that reach the emetic center either directly or indirectly via the CRTZ. In the case of motion sickness, the signal comes from the vestibular apparatus and travels through the CRTZ to the emetic center, although higher brain centers may also be involved. For a better understanding, let's go even deeper into these structures. The CRTZ is an area of the brain located outside the blood-brain barrier. When the CRTZ detects abnormal concentrations of circulating toxins, it signals the emetic center to initiate the cascade of events that cause vomiting. The CRTZ has seven known receptor types that mediate the vomiting signal. They are neurokinin 1, or NK1, 5-HT3, ENK, adrenergic, dopaminergic, muscarinic, and histaminergic receptors. Within the emetic center, there are three types of receptors currently identified: adrenergic, 5-HT1, and NK1. The NK1 receptor has recently been recognized as a key receptor involved in vomiting. A high concentration of NK1 receptors exists within the emetic center and CRTZ. But NK1 does not work alone in mediating the vomiting reflex. A neurotransmitter called substance P, produced by various tissues in the body, plays a key role in the vomiting response. Substance P demonstrates a high affinity for NK1 receptors. When substance P binds to NK1 receptors, a lock and key effect occurs, which results in the cascade of events that triggers vomiting. Now we have a more complete picture of the physiology of vomiting. The impulse is caused by a number of underlying conditions. signals to vomit ultimately converge on the emetic center. Neurotransmitters bind with receptors in the emetic center, such as NK1, to trigger the physical reflex of vomiting. With many underlying conditions and the multiple pathways that the vomiting impulse could take to the emetic center, it's not surprising that treatment is a challenge. And now, that challenge has been met by a new product from Pfizer Animal Health. Cerenia is the first veterinary-labeled antiemetic developed specifically for dogs. Cerenia safely and effectively treats and prevents vomiting from a variety of causes, including motion sickness. Let's look at the mode of action that makes Cerenia unique. Cerenia acts within the emetic center, where all vomiting signals ultimately converge. As you may recall, the neurotransmitter substance P binds to NK1 receptors, creating a lock and key effect that initiates vomiting. Cerenia is a selective and potent NK1 antagonist. By competitively inhibiting the binding of substance P to NK1 receptors, Cerenia blocks the vomiting cascade. Other medications currently used to treat vomiting in dogs do not target the NK1 receptor. For example, metoclopramide, a human product not approved for use in dogs, mainly antagonizes dopaminergic receptors located in the CRTZ. In medical conditions where vomiting is triggered via direct stimuli to the emetic center, metoclopramide is often ineffective. And of course, Cerenia has the distinction of being developed specifically for dogs. In clinical and field studies, Cerenia has demonstrated significant efficacy, proven to be 95% effective in the prevention of vomiting and 80% effective in the treatment of vomiting in dogs. It has a rapid onset of action within 1 hour of administration, and Cerenia is available in both injectable and oral formulations. Cerenia is a first-in-class veterinary NK1 receptor antagonist, a safe, effective, veterinary-labeled medication for the prevention and treatment of canine emesis.